day of the week to get the salty press. M-O-N-D-A-Y-S-U-C-K-S. Here comes more aggravation and a brand new week of stress. M-O-N-D-A-Y-S-U-C-K-S.
Come on, guys, it's not that bad, surely. Mr. Hunter here, form time, what would have been literacy. So, before we get into that, though, where in the world can you name the country and its capital? It is Namibia, and the capital, I hope I'm pronouncing this right, is Windhoek. So before we actually get into the work, some ideas for you to think about how to improve your writing. I'll let you read those and think about it. Some word scrambles. So the hint is that you are following the exact words. You just have to unscramble these letters to make a word. So that word is literal. Following the exact words means be literal. The next one, to make or become wider or larger, is to dilate. Third one, having two parts, D-P-E-L-U-X, can be unscrambled to make duplex. To diminish or become less, E-N-D-L-D-I-W, can be unscrambled to mean dwindle. And to make into law, as by legislative act, A-N-E-T-C, is enact. I hope politics club attendees particularly managed to get that one. Another activity for you to do, you can just take a screenshot of this and correct them, or just figure them out yourself, but try and correct these sentences if you can. Again, not mandatory, as I always remind you, but something to do just to get the brain going a bit, either in the morning or between your home learning lessons. Now what I'm going to introduce is a thought for the day. You can just have a think about this by yourself, or you can put it on your group chats, or have a chat with your parents or guardians or your siblings or anyone else in your household about it. But if I swap your watch for one exactly the same without telling you, is that stealing? It's not got a set answer. I'm not looking for a set answer, but if you do have any thoughts about that, I'd love to hear about them. It's just one of those ones to ponder. So that's enough from me. Have a great week. As always, I'm here to support you as much as I can in these circumstances. Do, particularly if I teach you, do feel free to contact me about your work if you are stuck on anything. And if there's, and to parents and students alike, if there's anything I can do to support or help you, then by all means, please feel free to contact me. And otherwise, I leave you with one final important message. About washing your hands.